Alright, everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. And... Alright, first we have to talk to Kyrie. So can you get the rest of the supplies, or are you listening? Yeah, I heard that. Okay, here's what you need to find. 2 logs, 1 cloth, 1 rope. Bring everything back here. If you need help, just ask. I'm counting on you. Okay, so... Kingdom Hearts, like I was saying in the last, part was really kind of my introduction to the full world of gaming, more than just turn-based RPGs like I was playing before. Come on, grab one. Or jump, that works too. And there were so many first experiences with this game. It really just holds a place in my heart, in my nostalgic heart, playing this game. So now we need a cloth and a rope, and let's see if I remember well enough what to do. And the first time I played this, like, I was having so much fun on Destiny Island, and I was just, like, battling these kids. I was at level 10 or something when I finally left Destiny Island for the first time. That was back when I didn't mind grinding so much. I hate it now, though. I hate grinding with a passion. It drives me up the wall when I have to just spend time pointlessly gaining experience points in order to get past the next story point. So now we have all the material, but here's the thing. You can battle each of your friends, and that's what we're going to do. At least once each before we move on to the next story point.
Hey, Sora! You feel lucky today?
Hey Sora, feeling like a little competition? You asked for it. Alright, let's go. You don't get much experience. But it's a nice way to get a feel for how gameplay works in this game, which is slightly different from Birth by Sleep. Like, I'm noticing that the guard button doesn't really work because there is no guard in this game. So we got, what was it? 7 whopping experience points? Status, that was it. So we've gained some experience points and we have 24 more experience points to get. We're already at level 3 though, so that isn't terrible. And apparently he hasn't learned the ability to grab onto the ledge yet.
The breeze feels great.
I don't know why they have these like weird just one line voice acting in this part. I don't get it. What are you up to these days? We never see you. Want a duel? Alright, now you're talking.
Okay, don't hold back. You ready?
She, I believe, is the easiest one to beat. Yep, there we go. But she's only worth 1 experience point, so...
Oh, I can't believe I lost!
And then we have Waka.
Hey, what's happening, man?
Yo, you up for a round? Sure, let's play. Plays for kids, this is serious.
Show me your stuff!
Waka, if you know what you're doing, you can beat him.
Hey,
Come on. There we go. There. But he's only worth one experience point too. I remember when I played this game though, instead of having, there were three options for this game, but in the original Kingdom Hearts there was only two. There was beginner mode and normal. They did not have a pro mode. I kind of think that maybe the beginner mode in this section, in this game, is easier than the beginner mode in the original, with normal kind of being somewhere between the beginner and the normal in the original Kingdom Hearts game, and Proud just being a bit harder. Did you get everything we need for the raft? I gave my stuff to Kairi. He saw how about a quick round, grab your sword. Riku is hard. Riku was hard to beat last time. I think I only beat him like a handful of times in my first playthrough. Oh, I forgot about his little jump thing. But because this is beginner mode, like I'm not taking nearly as much damage as I was the first time. Like I don't even really have to try that much. Spitzy, you don't have enough time to get out of the way when he goes back like that. Come on. Well, let's see if brute force like gets us to beat Riku or not. Damn it, I can't like jump out of the way. There we go. Oh, I still beat him though. That's a shocker. Now the score is 1-0. And it looks like you get a potion every time you beat him, so there we go. Or maybe that's just a one-time thing, I don't remember. But let's see, we've done that. What's our status now? We only have 8 more experience points to get. We'll probably battle through each person one more time and then finish up. On the right hand side, Kingdom Hearts Final Mix. Oh, beginner game, maybe. And apparently you're not allowed to move the camera in that space. So let's give Kairi our stuff, and I think this triggers a cutscene. Thanks, Sora. Here's something today. I found something today too. Here, it's yours. Eye potion. Tired? Want to call it a day? Yes, let's go home. Okay, it's getting late. We'll finish up tomorrow.
So, Kairi's home is out there somewhere, right?
Could be. We'll never know by staying here.
But how far could a raft take us?
Who knows? If we have to, we'll think of something else.
So, suppose you get to another world. What would you do there?
Well, I haven't really thought about it. It's just, I've always wondered why we're here, on this island. If there are any other worlds out there, why did we end up on this one? And suppose there are other worlds. Then ours is just a little piece of something much greater. So, we could have just as easily ended up somewhere else, right?
I don't know.
Exactly. That's why we need to go out there and find out. Just sitting here won't change a thing. It's the same old stuff. So let's go.
You've been thinking a lot lately, haven't you?
Thanks to you. If you hadn't come here, I probably would have never thought of any of this. Kairi, thanks.
You're welcome.
Sora! You wanted one, didn't you?
A Paupu fruit?
If two people share one, their destinies become intertwined. They'll remain a part of each other's lives, no matter what. Come on, I know you want to try it.
What are you talking?
Hey there, Donald. Good morning.
We've got a problem, Goofy. But don't tell anyone.
Oh, Queen Minnie?
Not even the queen.
Daisy?
No! It's top secret.
Oh, good morning, ladies.
What?
All right. So, I don't know. I like that bit. I kind of think, you know, now that I'm playing through this again, I didn't really question much, you know, the positioning of Riku in this story, of him kind of wanting out, and it kind of paints it as this dark thing. But I don't know. I'm actually thinking Riku was unjustly portrayed in this negative light. All he wanted to do was explore, really. So, there's Riku. But we're gonna hold off on doing all that side stuff. And proceed. With gathering all the materials first. The raft's almost ready. All we have to do now is load it with food. Hey, have you seen Riku? Oh, okay, so I guess we're not allowed to move on until, until we do the race with Riku, which I fucking suck at, by the way, so, like, we're not gonna win. And mostly because I always get hung up in two places. Jumping up on this fucking thing, and then jumping from, like, tree to tree to hit that star. I always fall. And I don't know. It's just... I hate the race. It's so stupid. Let's talk. Sora, our raft still needs a name. Let's see. How about Highwind? What would you call it? It doesn't matter. I don't know why they give us this option, because it doesn't make a goddamn bit of difference. Fine, Excalibur. That works.
Me?
Well, Excalibur. Hey, how about the usual? Let's do it. You guys at it again? Alright, I'll be the judge. The usual rules apply. Take any route you want. I'm gonna have to get to that star. And so, see those platforms? I always miss the platforms. First one to tag that tree and make it back here wins.
I'm captain. And if you win,
I get to share the Pow Poo with Kyrie.
Huh?
Deal? The winner gets to share a Pow Poo with Kyrie.
Oh, wait a minute.
Okay, on my count.
Riku strikes me as the one who's maybe a little bit more developmentally along than Sora. Not that Sora is immature, just that... There we go. Just that Riku seems to have hit puberty. Oh, are you fucking kidding me? I did not... God fucking... I actually stood a chance, and then I fucked it up. Oh man, that pisses me off. And for once, I didn't actually fall, which is rare. And is he just like walking back? Did you see that? And he's waiting and he waits for me to catch up to him so he can take off because he's a jackass. Jerk. Man, now the score is 1-1. Alright, we're naming the raft Highwind. So, yeah. I hate that race thing. I actually did better than... If Sora had not let go of that fucking zipline, I would have been fine. But he did, and now I'm kind of pissed about it. Today we collect provisions for our trip. Let's see, sir. You're looking for 1 seagull egg, 3 mushrooms, 2 coconuts, 3 fish. And fill that up with drinking water, but not from the ocean. Bring everything back here. If you need help, just ask. But, I mean, I think Riku has been maybe unfairly categorized by the game itself. He just wants... I mean, it actually seems like an allegory for... you know, when children reach that certain age where they want to explore something outside of what they've known their entire lives. And that's something that, like, should be celebrated, kind of, and not, like, oh, he's beautiful. I mean, maybe he has other intentions, and maybe that's part of it. I don't know. I'm just kind of like... His bit here and his desire to see the other worlds, and while it's kind of painted in this somewhat malevolent light, it's not inherently bad. I don't know. I have more sympathy for Riku now. Can I? Yes, I can lift this. And, you know, I know that they tried to paint, and in this game in particular, there's a lot of painting of Sora and Kyrie having this kind of budding relationship. And to a lesser extent, you see that in Chain of Memories and Kingdom Hearts 2, but I don't know. I don't think it really... Maybe I'm being... Let's see, reduces all elemental damage by 20%. Ooh, increases experience obtained by 30%. That's nice. I like that, actually. And that slightly raises defense. Nope, we're gonna keep the ribbon. So this is kind of a nice addition to beginner mode. You get some fancy... fancy armor items, accessory items. I will take it. Plus, anything that increases my EXP, like, yes, sign me up, because that means I don't have to grind later. But, I mean, you can really see the whole Disney-fied look in the first game. And I apologize if you heard that thumping sound. Someone's leaving the house and it just kind of reverberates everywhere. But, I don't know. And Kyrie, honestly, just seeing her again, like, I don't want to be annoyed by her, but I can't help but be a little annoyed by her. There's something about her voice or something. I don't know. Come on, just... There we go. Maybe I'm being too hard on Kyrie. Come on. There we go, seagull egg. And it looks like we are almost at time. So what I'm gonna do is just, find the second mushroom, and then we will call it a video. Which doesn't appear to be in here. I know that there's a second, because we have three mushrooms we have to find, and I know the second one is around here somewhere. I know where the third one is, the final one that we need. But I can't remember where the second one is to save my life. You know what, actually, we're at time. I'm not entirely sure where the second mushroom is, but next up is a cutscene. So I think we'll wait until next time. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.